Hello and welcome to the NBC2 Facebook page for our week one edition of Football Tonight. I'm Sean Barry, he's Derek Koppen. While last week was pretty much just for fun, the preseason, this week the games actually counted. It's week one of the high school football season here in Southwest Florida, which means, Derek, the pressure just gets turned up that extra notch.
And it really was. Let's go ahead and crank that thing to 10, 11,
11.
12.
Well,
that,
why
case,
not?
That was certainly the case, at least for our game of the week between Lehigh and North Fort Myers. Each teams do not like each other. A lot of talent on both sides. But oddly enough, even though it was paid on a Thursday, that really didn't stop Moody Field from rocking, and for good reason.
No, it was the biggest show in town on Thursday night. Chris Sneddon handing the head coaching duties for North Fort Myers last night. He was ready. So was this man, Richard Young. And I call him a man because, well, he's only 17, but he can do stuff like this. One, two, three, four, five. I counted five tacklers. He just shook off like they were nothing. 68 yards to the house. 7-0 Lehigh. That was his first touch of the game. Later on in the first quarter, Young was hurdling people now. This drive would end in nothing, a turnover on downs actually for Lehigh, but still Young is just hurdling people out there. Eventually, North Fort Myers would find the end zone. They would tie things up at 7 apiece. But here comes Mr. Young yet again. From 68 yards out the first time, how about from 35 out in the second touchdown of the game for him? His first half wasn't done, more on him. Later on in the first quarter, Tanner Helton, the QB from North Fort Myers, calls his own number. We are all tied up. Actually, no, we're not. Sorry, pardon my take right there. It's 21-17 at that point, Lehigh. And with 40 seconds left in the first half, why throw it
stiff arm
when you have Richard Young? You see why the likes of Alabama, Ohio State, Florida, FSU, Miami all want him on their rosters. Where will he sign? It's anyone's guess, but you know what's not a guess? He's probably going to score a touchdown against you sometime this season. Lehigh wins 28-22 in our game of the week.
He's a lock to be on Saturday, a lock. Up to Charlotte now. The Tarpons running out onto the field for the first time this season, taking on Coach Elgin Hicks and Island Coast Gators. Now, we were wondering pregame who would be taking over the quarterback duties for the blue and yellow for Charlotte. Well, John, go ahead and let's meet Keon Jones here. Mr.
Hello.
Jones takes the quarterback option. He isn't thinking first down. He's thinking touchdown that entire time. Down the side, and that made it 14-0. Let's go ahead and rock show in the end zone. Gotta love seeing that.
A little air guitar, why not?
Second quarter. Tarpon stretching their legs now with Troy McClary just absolutely refusing to go down. According to his max preps, he is only 5'7". Tiny but mighty right there with 21-0. Tarpons, they took control from that first kickoff. And this man right here, number 56, he was a menace on defense all night long. Saw him doing suicide sprints on the sidelines to get his energy out. That is Mr. Football right there.
The
Do
neck
not go
roll
on his
and everything,
field.
Yes.
Do not go on his field. That's old school linebacker right there. By the way, Charlotte, they do end up getting the win in this one. Final score, 35-7.
And next up, we join Laley and Bishop Rowe in overtime, tied at 14 apiece. And it's college rules, so every team gets a shot starting at their own 10. Laley goes first. And on fourth down, Brian Bachman finds Omar Vilsant for the touchdown, 21-14. The ensuing PAT, all important, the Vikings come up with the big block.
Ooh.
So Vero gets the ball, and they would need a touchdown and a PAT to win. On third down, it's Andrew Kelton finds his way into the end zone. It's all tied up at 20 in OT. It all came down to Deglan Cameron with ice in his veins. The Vikings' future on his right foot. He walks it off. Vero wins 21-20. Here is the overtime hero, Mr. Cameron.
As a kicker, you have to have the mindset of like nothing. It just slow down time. And I slew down the time and put the ball through the uprights. You know, it feels great giving the team their first win. You know, it's just great being part of the team.
You got to show the kicker some love on Friday nights. Not only did Cameron deliver Vero's first win of the season, but he also delivered that man, head coach Richie Rode, his first win in the black and gold. Over to the scoreboard now, Ida Baker proving, you know what, it might be top dog in the Cape, of course. You just saw Bishop Rowe top in Laley 21-20, and then Naples, yeah, they might just be top dog in all of Southwest Florida, 42-7 over Gulf Coast, who is still 0-4 against the Golden Eagles all time.
That is going to be a tough Naples out every single game this season. But the fun in Lee County, it was really just getting started, at least so far on this entire season, as Southwest Florida's newest team played its first varsity game ever. And It was a rivalry game at that.
Yeah, how about that? Call it the Gateway Bowl. Gateway High kicking off its inaugural season against their next-door neighbors from Gateway Charter. This was a fun one. Brand new stadium. The community was out. Let's get you out there. A new team in town, Gateway High, and head coach Colin O'Brien. He's pumped to play their next-door neighbors at Gateway Charter, and he was pumped because of this play, too. Josias Conairs went out to Xavier Gerardo, who comes up with the grab and the toe tap at the six. That drive would end with the first points in Gateway High football history, courtesy of the right foot of Ryan Thompson. Gateway over Gateway Charter, 3-0. Ensuing Griffin's drive, quarterback Christian Requimwa showing off his arm this time, finds a wide-open Ronaldo Charles, 61 yards on that bomb. Gateway Charter spoils the celebration at Gateway High tonight. They are winners 35-15 over their rivals from Gateway High.
That was a special night out at Edison Stadium for Coach Sam Sirianni Knight. And go ahead and check out son Sammy Sirianni Jr. right there, pin on his hat, coaching the Greenies. There's a lot to celebrate tonight for the Greenies, like this running back duo. First, check out Raynon Smith. One cut, good luck. Check your ankles, young man. You aren't going to stop that. Greenies up 28-2. Give me some love right there. Short yardage opportunity is Ricardo Noel. He's going to go ahead and punch it in. That gives
it's like
Greenies
they knew where you were,
a
Eric.
35-2. I promise I wasn't pointing at him or anything like that. Now, I mentioned some ankle snatching going on as well. No, I'm not going to put number 27 on blast. But goodness gracious right there from the Fort Myers, from the Greenies. I got a little bit of a damage there on my knee, but, you know, that was worth it to get that shot from Magic Tucker with the juke. Unbelievable game. That final score, 35-2. Fort Myers is another team looking pretty real.
Over to South Fort Myers next. It is the Glory Days Bowl between the Wolfpack and Cypress Lake, and Michael Tolbert is ready to dunk on the Panthers. I mean that quite literally. First possession for South, Duncan Smith with a little bubble screen over to Tolbert, and he is gone. 7-0, South Fort Myers out of the gates. Next, South Fort Myers possession. It's Smith finding a wide open Andre Jocelyn. 14, they don't make him any more wide open than that. 14-0, Wolfpack on their second possession. On their third possession, can you guess what happens this time around? It's Nathan Castor bouncing out to the outside, make it 21-0. The Chicken Wing Trophy, and I mean that literally. There you see it. The Chicken Wing Trophy is staying at South. Your final 28-6. South Fort Myers.
It's finger looking good. I'm pretty hungry right now. Let's get some final scores, though, from the night one more time. Barron Collier went and took on Sarasota, fell just short 19-16. A lot of close games were going on tonight in the entire area. Palmetto Ridge, they started 2021 with a 16-13 win over Key West. As we mentioned, they've lost a lot, so that is a big first opening win for them. And Golden Gate with an impressive 30-14 win over Cape Coral. So overall, an exciting night. Sean, what's your takeaways from this one?
Back-to-back wins for Golden Gate. They won their kickoff classic last week against Bonita Springs. They won against Cape Coral tonight. That'll be a team to watch out in Collier County. But you got to give it to Naples. They looked good last week. They looked even better this week. The Golden Eagles are going to be a tough out.
That's going to be a tough one. Cannot wait to see Dunbar get back on the field. Hopefully they get back and healthy and safe to return after their game tonight with Port Charlotte was canceled. That's going to be fun to see them. But, yes, that is my takeaway. Takeaway number two, Richard Young, let us know the supplements. Let us know what's going on. How you getting like that? You look like you're 25 years old already, man. You got to slow down a little bit.
He hurdled another human being like it was nothing. Like it was nothing. Richard Young, calm down. By the way, he had over 200 yards rushing those three touchdowns in the first half. Not even the entire game, in the first half, over 200 yards rushing. So the Richard Young Show is definitely open for business this season in Southwest Florida.
Folks, we're spoiled. We're spoiled, and we're going to have you covered. That's all the time that we do have for tonight, but we are going to be right back here for some Week 2 action next week. Same time, same place, and same stud football players from all over tonight, right here on Football Tonight on Facebook. For now, that's Sean Berry right there. I'm Derek Kopp. Have a great rest of your night and a safe weekend.